Hi, my name is Cletus Canelli. I'm here to talk about my week with the acoustic guitar project guitar. The first thing I want to say, when I received it, it was lots and lots of names on the face of the guitar, people who had taken part in the project. And I was I wasn't surprised, but it was a warm feeling to see how many people I knew. I'm more of an introvert by nature, as a lot of songwriters are, and I thought, well, I actually know quite a lot of people in the DC area, which is a great DC has a great music community. I feel like there's, as well as really talented people, there's a feeling of support, mutual support for each other. I think we're all happy for each other when we get something good happens for us. A few challenges. One was writing on a guitar that's not my guitar. I pretty much write every song on my 6-string or my 12-string. This guitar was different. It felt different, and as a result, I wrote a song with a C sharp minor seventh in it, which I was searching for the chord. I knew I could hear it in my head, and I found it. I thought, man, where did that come from? That's a jazz chord. It's not part of my usual bag of chords, which is why you write on a different guitar from time to time. So that was a that was a good challenge, and it stretched my brain muscles and actually my hand muscles, because my guitar has great action. The other challenge was the deadline. I generally take much longer than a week for the songs to gestate for me, and it was hard because I knew I would have not put it off, but I would just allow it to keep gestating throughout the days and weeks and whatever. So again, good challenge. The third challenge was getting the song recorded in one take on one Zoom mic. It is a humbling kind of blow to the ego to realize how difficult it is to play and sing a song and release it into the world. Live is one thing. Live, there, you know, the little blemishes and whatnot, they come and go, they pass, we move on. But to put a song like that on the internet was tough for me. I'm used to, in my studio, taking the best vocal take, the best guitar take, doing some tweaking, nipping and tucking, borrowing from other takes, and you end up with a kind of a greatest hits version of each song. So that was again a good challenge and a good reminder of the leveling effect of having to actually play your guitar and sing it and let everybody hear it. So they asked where I wrote it. Mostly here in my studio, a little bit upstairs, but mostly here, and mostly without any. Completely without any other. Occasionally I'll write with a drum sample, but this was just me and the guitar, because that was the way we were instructed to write. So what it's about, it's sort of semi-autobiographical, because I tend to overthink things and I'm riddled with self-doubt. And so in the song, the singer is singing to somebody who is going through that. And I originally had a metaphor of getting out of the city and going into the country where the air is clearer, and having that as a metaphor for the mind. And somehow it ended up being vines. It's called the vines. And hacking through the vines in our minds that our thoughts and doubts and any other little insecurities that we have. So the song is kind of partly about writing songs. But it's much broader than that. It's about hacking through those the self-doubt that we have and the what we've inherited from our upbringing, and coming out on the other side without as much clogged mind and clogged thoughts, and feeling better. So it was a good week. It was I'm grateful for it, and it left me with a warm feeling that I'm part of something. Creative process that a lot of people have taken part in. A lot of people in DC on this particular guitar, but a lot of people in other cities on other guitars, and it just gave me a good feeling. So thanks for listening, and let's keep writing.